Good morning, students, and welcome to today's class. So in the last class, we studied how to do division by 10, 100, and 1000. And also, we saw a few tests of divisibility. So we saw tests of divisibility for 5 and 10, and also for 2, 4, and 8. So today, we'll see rules of divisibility for 3, 6, and 9. And also, we'll do a few word problems and multiplication and division. Alright, so first let's see what we did in the last class. So we saw when we divide a given number by 10, right? So the ones digit of that number is the remainder and the remaining digits become the quotient. Correct? Same way when I divide the given number by 100, the tens and the ones digit of the number become the remainder and the remaining digits become the quotient. And when I divide a number by 1000, the ones, tens and hundreds place together become the remainder and the remaining places become the quotient. So how many of zeros are there? Okay, so when you see that whenever a number is divided by 10, 100 or 1000 and so on, the remainder has as many digits as the number of zeros in the divisor. So the remainder will have that many digits, as many as the zeros are there in the divisor. Okay, and the remaining digits form the quotient. So this is what happens when you divide a number by 10, 100, 1000, 10,000 and so on. Okay, then we saw rules of divisibility. So first we saw the rule of divisibility for 5 and 10. So what's the rules of divisibility for 5? The rule of divisibility for 5 is if the digit in ones place is 5 or 0, then that entire number will be divisible by 5. Okay, if the digit in ones place is 5 or 0, then the number will be divisible by 5. Now for 10, if the digit in ones place is 0, then the number will be divisible by 10. Okay, the ones place should be 0 for the number to be divisible by 10. Okay, so this is divisibility rule for 5 and 10. So now let's see divisibility rule for 2, 4 and 8. So we saw that for 2, the digit in the ones place should be an even number or 0. That is, if the digit in evens place is either 2, 4, 6, 8 or 0, then the number will be divisible by 2. Alright, then divisibility rule for 4. Okay, the digit in tens and ones place taken together should be divisible by 4. Okay, the digit in tens and ones place taken together should be divisible by 4, then the entire number will be divisible by 4. Alright, same way for 8, the rule for divisibility for 8, the digit in hundreds, tens and ones place taken together should be divisible by 8. So when you divide these three digits, that is hundreds, tens and 8, if you get a remainder of 0, it means that that is divisible by 8. So the entire number will be divisible by 8 if the last three digits are divisible by 8. Okay, so this is what we learned in the last class. So in today's class, we will learn tests of divisibility for 3, 6 and 9. So what is the divisibility rule for 3? Okay, if the sum of the digits of a given number is divisible by 3. So whatever number you have given you, you have to find the sum of the digits of that number. So here for example, they have taken the number 17,286. So I'll find the sum of the digits here. That is 1 plus 7 plus 2 plus 8 plus 6. Okay, so when I add all these digits, I get a sum of 24. Now you should see if 24 is divisible by 3. If that sum is divisible by 3, then the number will be divisible by 3. So here 24 is divisible by 3. Okay, since 24 is divisible by 3, 17,286 is also divisible by 3. Okay, so this is the divisibility rule for 3. Then coming to divisibility rule for 6. Now, if the number is divisible by 2 and 3, then that number will be divisible by 6. So the given number should be divisible by both 2 and 3. If it is only divisible by 2, or if it is only divisible by 3, then it will not be divisible by 6. It should be divisible by both 2 and 3. So here they have taken 17,286. So check the divisibility for 2, if it is divisible by 2. Since in 1's place we have 6, 6 is an even number. So this entire number is divisible by 2. Okay, and for to see if it is divisible by 3, we just now did it, right? We added all the digits, we got the sum as 24. And 24 is divisible by 3. So 17,286 also will be divisible by 3. So this number is divisible by both 2 and 3. Hence, it is divisible by 6 also. Okay, so this is the divisibility rule for 6. Then coming to divisibility rule for 9. It is same as 3. If the sum of the digits is divisible by 9, then the number will be divisible by 9. So here they have taken the number 17,289. Okay. So when you add all these digits, so 1 plus 7 plus 2 plus 8 plus 9, you get a sum of 27. Now here 27 is divisible by 9. Okay, we know that 27 is divisible by 9. So 17,289 will also be divisible by 9. Okay, so these were the divisibility rules for 3, 6 and 9. Now let's solve the problems that are given in your textbook on this. So we did question 1, 2 and 3 in the last class. So today's class we will do question number 4. So here they've told test whether the following numbers are divisible by 3, 6 and 9. Okay, so let's do these questions. So here the first question is 510, correct? So first what you'll do, we'll find the sum of the digits. So sum of digits here is 5 plus 1 plus 0, that is 6. So 5 plus 1 is 6 and 6 plus 0 is 6. Now to see if this is divisible by 3. So we'll see if the sum of digits is divisible by 3. The sum of digits here is 6. So we know that 6 is divisible by 3. 3 2's is 6, correct? So it will be divisible by 3. So 510 is divisible by 3. Okay, now we'll check if it is divisible by 6. Now to see if it is divisible by 6, first you have to check if it is divisible by 2 and 3. Now we already know it is divisible by 3 because we have done it here. Now let's see if it is divisible by 2. Now 510 has 0 in its 1's place, correct? And so it makes 510 a even number. Since 510 is an even number, it is divisible by 2. Now we know that 510 is divisible by both 2 and it is also divisible by 3 as we have seen here. So 510 is divisible by 6. Okay, it is divisible by 3 and it is divisible by 6. Now how to see if it is divisible by 9? We know that we need to check if the sum of digits is divisible by 9. So here the sum of digits we have already done, it is 6. But is 6 divisible by 9? No, 6 is smaller than 9, so it will not be divisible by 9. So 510 is not divisible by 9. So this number 510 is divisible by 6. It is divisible by 3, it is divisible by 6, but it is not divisible by 9. Okay, let's do another problem. Question B, 3125. So here first we'll find the sum of the digits. So what is the sum of digits? 3 plus 1 plus 2 plus 5. Okay, so 3 plus 1 plus 2 plus 5 gives you a sum of 11. Now is 11 divisible by 3? It is not. 11 is not divisible by 3. So 3125 is also not divisible by 3. Now to check if it is divisible by 6. See if it is divisible by 2 and 3. Now to check if it is divisible by 2, check the 1's place. 1's place has 5. 5 is an odd number. So it makes the entire number an odd number. So this number is not divisible by 2. And as we have seen above, it is not divisible by 3 also. So 3125 is not divisible by 6. Okay, so this number is not divisible by 3. It is not divisible by 6 also. Then, since 11 is not divisible by 9, right? 11 is not divisible by 9 also. So 3125 will not be divisible by 9. So this number is not divisible by 3, 6 or 9. Okay, so this was question B. Now, question number C, 7,281, right? So first we'll find the sum of digits, that is 7 plus 2 plus 8 plus 1. So when you add all that, you get a sum of 18. Now see if 18 is divisible by 3. We know that 3 sixes are is 18, correct? So 18 will be divisible by 3. That makes 7,281 divisible by 3. Now, we saw if it is divisible by 3, we have to see if it is divisible by 6 also. Now here, we have to check if it is divisible by 2 first. To check if it is divisible by 2, we have to see if what's there in the 1's place. In 1's place, we have the digit 1, which is an odd number. So that number will not be divisible by 2. Correct? So this number is not divisible by 2, but it is divisible by 3. Correct? But we know that for the number to be divisible by 6, it should be divisible by both 2 and 3. So this number is not divisible by 6. Okay? Now check if check the divisibility by 9. Check if the sum of the digits is divisible by 9. That is 18. Is 18 divisible by 9? We know that 9 twos are is 18. Correct? So 18 will be divisible by 9. So 7,281 is divisible by 9. So 7,281 is divisible by both 3 and 9, but not 6. Okay, so these were tests of divisibility and rules of divisibility. Now we'll solve a few word problems. So you all know what are word problems, so let's solve them. We'll take a few examples and do it first. So here 210 passengers can travel in an aircraft. How many passengers would have traveled in 4 flights of the aircraft in 7 days? Assume that all the flights were filled to capacity. So how many passengers are there in one flight? 210. Okay, so they are asking how many would have traveled in 4 flights of the aircraft in 7 days. So number of flights in, you have to find first. So number of flights in 7 days will be 7 into 4. That is 28. Okay, and to see how many passengers have traveled in 28 flights, you will multiply 210 with 28. So when you do the multiplication and all, you will get 5,880. Okay, so 5,880 passengers would have traveled in 7 days. Okay. Okay, so next example, a rice dealer wants to pack 1,330 kgs of rice equally in packets of 7 kgs each. Okay, how many packets would be obtained? So he wants to divide 1,330 kgs of rice equally in packets of 7 kg each. So each packet should be 7 kgs. So how many packets you would get? Okay, so to find that, you will divide 1,330 divided by 7. So first, quantity of rice to be divided is 1,330 kgs. Rice in one packet is 7 kgs. So to find number of packets, you will divide. So when you divide here, see here, 7 ones are 7. So 13 minus 7 will get 6. So you will bring down 3, 63. We know that 7 nines are 63. So we will subtract from 63, we will get 0. So we will bring down the next 0. And we'll do 7 zeros a 0. So it will be 190. So you'll get 190 packets. Alright. Then example 3. 1,376 students had to commute in 32-seater bus for the Republic Day parade. How many buses would be required? 32-seater commute means to travel. Okay. And in each bus, there are 32 seats. So they're asking how many buses would be required. So what you'll do, you'll divide 1376 by 32. So number of students is 1376. Okay, students in one bus is 32, and buses needed will be 1376 divided by 32. So you can write the first few multiplication tables of 32 and then divide using the same procedure. So you'll get a quotient of 43 here. So the for thus 43 buses would be needed for 1376 students. Okay. So now let's solve exercise 3.7 questions. Okay. So first question is, a garment factory packed 28 shirts in one box. If 425 such boxes were sent to outlets in a week, find the total number of shirts that were sent. Okay, so here they're telling that a factory packed 28 shirts in one box. Okay, in one box, 28 shirts can fit. So they're asking if 425 such boxes were sent. Okay, then how many shirts will be there in those 425 boxes? So to find out what we'll do, we'll multiply 425 with 28. So number of shirts in a box is 28. Number of boxes is 425. So number of shirts in 425 boxes will be 425 multiplied by 28. Okay, so when we multiply, okay, using you know how to multiply using a two-digit multiplier. So when you multiply, you'll get 11,900 shirts. Okay, so the answer is 11,900 shirts. So the number of shirts that was sent to the outlets is 11,900. Now, question number 2. Sunita earned rupees 350 per day. Find the amount she earns in 65 days. So in one day, Sunita is earning how much? 350 rupees. So how much will she earn in 65 days is what they're asking us here. Okay. So her earnings per day is rupees 350. The number of days she is working is 65. So amount she earns in 65 days will be 350 into 65. So when you multiply, you'll get rupees 22,750. So she earns rupees 22,750 in 65 days. Okay. So this was question number 2. Now, here they're telling the total amount for the costume for the school annual day for 15 students of class 4A was 6,375 rupees. How much did each one have to pay? So total amount for 15 costumes is how much? Rupees 6,375. And how many students are there? 15. So amount each student had to pay would be 6,375 divided by 15. Okay, so here you can write the first few multiples of 15. So when you do that, you can see 15 fours are 60. So we'll write 60 here. 63 minus 60 will be 3. Now we'll bring down 7. So this became 37. Nearest to 37, 15 tables is 15 twos are 30. So we'll write 30 here. So 37 minus 30 is 7. Now we'll bring down the next digit 5. Okay. And 15 fives are is 75. So 75 minus 75 will be 0. And our quotient here is 425. Right. So the amount each student paid for the costume is rupees 425. Okay, so answer for question 3 is rupees 425. Then question number 4. Reema wanted to check if she would be able to divide 735 stamps equally among 9 classes. Without actual division, find out if it is possible. Now here what they're telling, Reema wants to check if she can divide, she has a few stamps, 735 stamps. So she wants to check if she can divide them equally among 9 classes. So when they say equally, it means that there shouldn't be any remainder when you divide. So it means that the number 735 should be divisible by 9 if she wants to divide it equally. Okay, so what you can do without doing the actual division, you can check using the rule of divisibility. So first what you'll do, first we'll find out the sum of the digits. So here 7 plus 3 plus 5 gives you a sum of 15. Now 15 is not divisible by 9. That means 735 will not be divisible by 9. So therefore she cannot divide the stamps equally among 9 classes. She will not be able to divide it equally among 9 classes. Okay, so these were the word problems for this chapter. Okay, so now for your homework, try to do question number 5. They have asked 24 pieces of soap can be packed in one carton. How many cartons would be needed to pack 3024 pieces? So what you have to do, you have to divide to get the number of cartons. Okay, so do this question number 5 for homework, and also question number 6 over here. Test whether 74,235 is divisible by 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 9 and 10. Okay, so do question 6 here and question 5 over here on page 132. Okay, and we'll start with a new chapter in the next class. Alright, thank you.